Was this here before? Wow. A very large red t-shirt with an impressive print stands out from the other garb. Oh yeah? Oh yeah. The print depicts a muscled man striding toward you, a giant sword in each hand, encircled by burning embers. Behind him is a cluster of cabins engulfed in flames. Beneath him are the words Heimdall burning. Sniff. Smells like worn cotton and a little old sweat there. Perception says worn cotton with a side of flea market or trash bin. Sniffing is okay, says the shopkeep, but please don't try anything on. Can't have you leaving your photon emissions in the fabric of things you're not going to buy. Inland Empire says you're not imagining it. Photon emissions. What is he talking about? That's a Red Man from Heimdall t-shirt you got there. Hell yeah, man. The shopkeep sounds enthusiastic. I don't usually carry printed tees, but this one was just a pure exemplar. You must be a serious Man from Heimdall fan. A fan? No, I wouldn't go that far. But I do think the Heimdallerman saga is an integral part of our shared reality. Most people don't think that the Man from Heimdall really existed, but they're wrong. Wait, you mean the Man from Heimdall was real? I mean, even if the man didn't exist before the adventure novels, the stories have made it so that he has. It's simple, really. Okay, Kim sounds incredulous. You sound skeptical. It's not that complicated. All that's required is a more robust understanding of cause and effect. Besides, I've been to Katla, though not quite as far north as the Heimdall, and watched the northern lights travel across the sky. Very unique and energetic tides there. Conceptualization says his theory isn't exactly incoherent, but its logic does suggest some unusual neural activity. Interesting. Inland Empire says very, very unique energies indeed. Geomagnetic ley lines, one might even say. How much are you selling the t-shirt for? 2 real. Oh. The lieutenant raises his eyebrows. That's dirt cheap. Couldn't you just give it to me for free then? He frowns, but why? I don't have an option to actually buy it. I have to ask for it for free. Because I'm a broke cop with what I sent to my name? I sympathize, I do, but this is a for-profit enterprise. Okay, I've thought it over and I want to buy the shirt. Welcome to Heimdall, officer. Alright. What do I got? Oh! The map wall. And I can try Bird's Nest Roy again. I gotta go to the map wall. Check out what we got. So it's +1 physical instrument for inspiring musculature, +1 shivers for sprawling saga, and -2 authority, too old for this shirt. The man from Heimdall is standing in front of a burning village, dual-wielding his ever-present Zweihanders. His muscles look ready to burst out of the two-dimensional print and into your three-dimensional life. Yeah, I'm probably not gonna wear it. Let's check with him.
I see you were wounded in the recent altercation. A speedy recovery to you, officer.
He says with a grave nod.
Now, what can I do for you?
I do have something else to sell. I guess I don't need this anymore. I have a fascinating photo of a corpse here. Oh, no, I don't like those kinds of objects. No, Sal. He barely even looks at it. Do you know what the tattoos mean? He frowns. Aphotic paths? Counter-radiance networks? Anti-magnetism? It's darkness. That's all I know. Sell me something lighter. Rhetoric says, you have absolutely no idea what aphotic paths are, but the tattoos on the man are not that. The armor, I think I'm wearing the gauntlets, so I really don't want to sell that. I do have another postcard, though. There you go. Now I made money. Okay, is Roy high? And if yes, then what is he on? Electrochemistry. plus two for both Roy's price as a strange and odd brain activity, and plus one for Roy doesn't really sleep. Fail, huh? Nope, still no clue. You obviously haven't been doing enough drugs lately. Wow. Is this actually even important? I have three skill points. Let's put one into electrochemistry then. Which is where. Trying again. Put the flashlight away.
Hello again. How can I help you?
Higher now, 92%. Feeling warm and enthralled by the movement of light while the mind continues to race forward? Lucky bastard. He's probably on Pyhelodon. It's tough to come by on the street. What's that? A drug developed by the military to treat and prevent radiation sickness. It has psychedelic side effects, and it makes your eyes turn yellow. Sir, could you take off your sunglasses? I'd like to check your eyes. Why on earth? He struggles away from the glass, but quickly recomposes himself. These are prescription. I can't really see without them. There's a note of indignation in his voice, Empathy says. Interesting. It's pretty obvious that you're under the influence, sir. He frowns. Pyhelodon is just something I... You know, since the People's Pile disaster. He coughs, as if to mark his words. I was with the Emergency Relief Brigade. Had to take it for radiation sickness. Pain Threshold says he's taking it for mental and emotional, not physical pain these days. The People's Pile? What's that? A bad idea. Some poor leftist built a particle decay generator in hopes of bringing affordable electricity to underserved communities. It malfunctioned. Radioactive waste everywhere. Probably some of it in you, too. Tell me more about this emergency relief brigade you were part of. He points at the white triangle on his orange safety jacket. We were an all-volunteer force, self-organized, tried to help fire brigades contain the spill. Perception says, on the patch, gamma radiation lines cross with a red drop of blood. Endurance says, tough son of a gun, this one. Respect. I lived by the river since I was a small boy. The Esperance didn't have the heart to let it all go to crap without trying to do something to help out. There wasn't much the volunteer force could do, however. We wasted years in the river mud, years getting sick. He looks at the spiraling light and stops. It must have been tough. Radioactive cleanup. He hesitates. There's a reason why everyone's trying to forget any of it ever happened, and why no one has ever tried to repair or replace the pile. So much disappointment, and early deaths, cancer mostly. And we knew all that was coming even as we were cleaning up as best we could. Whose fault was it that the generator failed? No one's. Everyone's. He sighs and shakes his head. Empathy says, so much bitterness. A bunch of poor people kept themselves a primitive nuclear reactor, hoping for the best. What do you think is going to happen? How did you end up running a pawn shop? The cleanup happened 15 years ago. I was young then. Later, my second aunt died, left me the shack and the assorted junk in it. So I came to Martinez. People told me, don't go there. It's a bleep hole. I said, people, we've just had a nuclear pile meltdown. I'm going to get as far from Farberg as I can. Still in the same city, but... He shrugs. Thanks for telling me. He shrugs. I like theory more than story. Outward movement, not vortices. Electrochemistry says, yeah, you got to get in on those vortices, man. My man. I don't need Paralodon. Well, that was interesting. Kind of reminds me of the figurine that we found in the Rural. Are these royalist soldiers? Which ones? The man peers from his glass box. Ah, those. Yes, they are. I find the paint job a bit gaudy, but children like bright colors indiscriminately. Is this probably these choices were here already? Maybe, he says. Alright, we're done in here. Alright, so we're gonna run across here and then we turn on music. Not yet, I can't. Need to get farther away. Let's get up here. Yeah, hopefully I cut that out. That was music. That was music that we can't have playing. There we go. Done. Alright, so once again, not much to do. What we do have is rather important. Don't say anything new with these people. How about her?
Our tenant, the policeman. I hope the waves don't keep you up at night. What can I help you with?
I got shot. Even I can see that. I told you not to bring your trouble with you, policeman. We've got troubles of our own here. Though I suppose you took the worst of it. Turns out you were your own ill omen. The woman chuckles to herself. I guess you were right. The men with guns were coming for me after all. She nods. I'm not sure those were the last of the men with guns either. There were always more coming for your kind, officer. Hand-eye coordination says then we'll be ready for them. Check in here. Mister, what were you doing in my fireplace? There was a phasmid in it. I was trying to catch it. Oh, okay. She nods seriously. Bye. So we could check in at the church, and we check with these guys over here. And then there's just the guy and his son over by the Feld building.
Man, you're like bleeding there. Reality's really messed you up.
The legend, he's back and thirsty. I got smokes and piss and a little speed to spice things up.
Danko.
Alright, nothing new there except for a couple. Well, a tidbit from the one guy. So I can check in with these guys over here and then the church. Well, the guy and the boy, anyway. Are they gone? They're gone! They're not here anymore. Alright. So I'm just checking on everyone before we go. Check this. A random number, and I did that already. Andre.
Oh, hey, man. It's good to see you.
Hard cop is back. Let's see if anything these guys have anything to say.
A better deal! Yeah! Medium car!
Yes, what is it?
Form a theory on a 2mm hole in the world. Plus ones for heard of doomed commercial area and investigated same. Plus two have heard of motorway south and motorway south complete. Success. Logic says you don't have to. You already have. A long time ago. What? Wait, how? These thoughts formed in you somewhere in a long forgotten discussion behind a kitchen table in the evening light. Inland Empire's drink says drinking coffee and smoking with a friend. Suna, it is the origin point of the pale. Really? What? The swallow. It's how it starts. It's baby pale. But she looks up and there's fear in her eyes as she considers the possibility. But pale isn't here. We're thousands of kilometers from the edge. The pale is only an effect, a transition between the world and that. Then what is that? Logic says, it's nothing. No, it's less than nothing. No. It's less than nothing, the final rest state for reality. Imagine if all this never was. Then the pale is simply a gradient. But the gradient, it clearly hasn't started yet. We're here and the pale is not. One day when it's larger, it will be. I understand, she closes her eyes. A theory of the pale where, instead of an outer ocean, it metastasizes, like a cancer or a mold, erupting in points inside the world. This is one of those places. She's silent for a second, then opens her mouth. According to this, how long? Until it starts swallowing? It's already starting. Starting with sound. And information, she nods. Causing data losses in the East Insulindian Front. Have you considered why it's formed in a church? And also when or how it might start growing, or if it has other effects in addition to sound and data. Empathy says, an intellectual hunger fills her now, casting fear inside. Fear aside. Kim says, I also have a question, since we're piling them on. How do you know this? I'm not doubting you. I'm simply curious as to how a detective of the RCM, Esprit de Corps says, knows how to think this. It didn't form in a church. The church formed around it. Of course, a pinewood sarcophagus or a, she looks for words, a containment facility of some kind, built by the first settlers. Yes, acting on an instinctual level, or religious practices we've forgotten. I have considered the same. The bad news is, there were 7 pinewood churches built in the first decade of Revachol's settlement. Most of them were burnt down during the Revolution, or repurposed before, during the Suzerain. I'm not saying all of them have one in them, but Half-Life says, some of them might. A black grain hanging in the air. I guess this is my answer to Kim. I think I've had this thought before. That's how I know. An amateur entrepreneurial police officer. I'd like to say I've heard stranger things, but I'm not sure. This is a hell of a guess, however. Well worded, I might add. Suna says, yes, it is very interesting, but I wouldn't say you know. This is a guess when it's going to have to be proved by entrepreneurial scientists. All the failed businesses in the doomed commercial area? All the failure in Martinez? You think the presence of that puncture has somehow influenced the outcome of events here? Even, say, software development? Empathy says she had already made up her mind when she heard it. Some kind of great and uncaring force had to play a part. It wasn't only them. All the failed businesses and ideologies, there's something wrong here. I told the producers we need to go and move to a normal office building with amenities, but no, The artists like the milieu. The writers like the history. She shakes her head. I told them. I should let people still working in there know about this. They might be affected. You mean Plaisance and the dice maker? There was almost no one left when we packed up. Yes, both of them deserve to know. Guess we're hanging back there. Then go tell them, she smiles. Suddenly encouraging. One day all the world will be like that 2mm hole. She falls silent. The wind blows in through the hole in the stained glass window, cold and moist. I'm going to leave that out, but the rest, some of this I can use to start to explain this to the rest of the team. Maybe I'll sound mad, but... Kim says, ma'am, you will certainly sound mad. She shrugs. One more thing. Maybe a club for anodic music isn't the worst thing you could erect around this particular point in space. I'm really not sure. The club is the only thing keeping this place and the rest of reality together. I wouldn't go so far as to... Yeah! Once the light is on in the universe, it will never go out. Thank you, Egghead, Kim says. Let's leave it at that, shall we? We have unentropenetic detection to perform in this district. I do have one mystery that still needs solving. The radio ghost in the doomed commercial area's electronic doorbell. The creepy woman! She slaps her forehead. We were wondering about that when we worked there, but I had completely forgotten about it ever since. It must be entropenetic crosstalk, the one you get in radios and long-distance calls. Now it makes sense, with Pale right on our doorstep. Incredible, the lieutenant murmurs. This would also explain why we get it on the police radio all the time. Really, the crosstalk? It's quite common, actually, Suna says. When the signal gets routed through Pale, all kinds of irregularities take place. You may hear snippets of someone else's conversation, or the voice of your former lover, or an echo of an event that took place 100 years ago. Pale is a shroud of memories, and it doesn't really distinguish to whom those memories belong to. You could hear anything. Makes sense. Thanks for explaining that to me. Anytime, she smiles. Alright. All four back door hardcore.
Yo, man! What's on your mind?
Hardcore.
She nods to you with respect and turns off her recording device. I don't know why I'm showing off to people. I got shot in the leg. Ouch. She looks at your leg. I did notice you were limping, but I thought maybe it was your thing or something. When I was 16, I used to date this guy who had a limp, but it only showed when he was sober, so I guess it wasn't real or something. I don't know. She shrugs, eyes glazed over. Then turned back to you. Anyway, shot in the leg. I'm sorry, man. That must suck. Alright. So I have informed Plaisance about the source of doom. Suna's research has led you to discover a 2mm origin point of Pale in the DeLorean Church of Humanity down the coast. This might be negatively affecting the entire neighborhood, including the doomed commercial area where Plaisance works. Tell her about it. And same where the dice maker works. Tell her about it. Okay. Gart, I imagine, too. So I head back there.
Oh, hey, man. It's good to see you.
But they might have something to say after this new discovery.
A better deal! Yeah! Medium car!
Oh, we got a thing. Cleaning out the rooms. Someone's been walking around in your dreams lately looking for something. Tidying up, rearranging, storing away all the unrealized dreams, putting old pains in boxes. The worst nightmares have settled down for a while. A spot of light on the bedroom door after the dark, the fluttering of eyelids in the spring sun, a thought that arises only to disappear again, and yet there's a pattern emerging. Well, if I get rid of one of these... Oh, motorway south. Right! I need to check out that wall. Damn it. Let's head for the wall. Can we talk to what's his name? I don't see him. All they need is for some more people to show up. Okay, just skip to back of the bookshop.
It's always nice to see you here. You bring good energy.
Plaisance, I have something to tell you. I found the actual source of doom. What do you mean, the actual source? She clutches her pendant, clearly irritated. Are you here to lecture me about economics again? My investigation has led me to discover a 2-millimeter intraplanetary hole in reality. That's the source of doom, both in the commercial area and in Martinese. A what? A tiny hole in reality. It may be connected with Pale, an origin point of sorts. It would explain why historically so many things have ended in failure here in Martinese. So entropy, yeah. Ma'am, Kim says, what he's telling is true. We found an intraplanetary anomaly in the small Pinewood church down the coast. I don't mean to be an alarmist, but... And more research is needed, but it's not looking good. But that's not in any of the ancient texts. How am I supposed to protect my bookstore from that? Redrick says, tell her the truth. It's out of her hands. Protected by hope. By refusing to give up. Find your own answer. You can't protect it. Not against the Pale. Close up the shop and try to get as far away from this thing as possible. Close the shop? But it's all I have. No, there must be a way. Especially now that Annette is settling in at school again. She's finally making friends in this place. She looks at her daughter, quietly studying in the corner of the shop. No, we can't leave Martinez. We can't. Thank you for your help. In any case, you're welcome back here anytime. Okay. Alright, that's one done. Actually, it's this. Talk to the little girl again, in case maybe she will convince her mother.
Hi, Ace Detective. Are you here for more books?
Nope, sorry, alright. Dicemaker. Run through here again. Flashlight. Hello again. I think I found the actual source of the curse. I thought we agreed that the curse isn't real. Yes, well, about that. I'm listening. She leans back in her chair, arms crossed over her chest. There's a 2-millimeter hole in reality located in a church on the other side of the canal. I think it may be related to Pale. Excuse me? She sits up, visibly agitated. A 2-millimeter hole in reality? This can't be true. I'm afraid it is, ma'am, Kim says. Suna Lukanen killed, the former lead programmer of Fortress Accident, made the discovery. Suna is involved in this? She appears to take this in, while chatter from her headphones continues unabated. So it's even worse than I thought. It's not just the commercial area that's cursed, it's the entire world. Perception says she looks outside the window where daylight has filled the yard. What? No, I wouldn't go as far to say that the entire world is doomed. Just Martinez? She gives you a rueful smile and takes a look around. In any case, thank you for stopping by. It's good to have an answer, even if I can't claim to understand it fully. I'm surprised it's still locked since we found the hole. Why hasn't her business failed? Is that worth spending a point on? I don't know. I have 2. Now I'm gonna save it. I do want to talk to guard about it. That's not on the... That's not on the list, I know. I can go out this way. Music off. It's the routine. Oh, the map wall. I keep forgetting that. My God, what's wrong with me? Gart.
You son of... Is there something I can do for you?
Unless it's under there, we can't warn him. Because we're thinking this is the same. This is connected too. Did you see the huge burning graffito outside? Yes. Very responsible. Come on, you gotta admit, it was pretty cool. Looked pretty hot to me. He stops, realizing that this is also a compliment. At least nothing bad actually happened, he adds with a sigh. Endurance says he's so exhausted following recent events, he doesn't even have the energy to really get on your case. You don't have a choice to say anything about the 2mm hole, but there's a peephole in the wall upstairs. He startles. What wall? Upstairs in the secret back room, right next to Classier's bedroom. I found it when I found the pinball machines. Actually, no, I found it later. I'll have it fixed at once. Thank you for letting me know. I assure you, the whirling does not abide up spying on its guests. Composure says the color is drained from his face. Oh, could it be him? Are you sure you haven't been spying on your guests? Absolutely not. He breathes in and out. Screw you for even implying it. It wasn't me. It wasn't my staff. The establishment will look into it and ascertain what it was. Drama says, well, he's definitely not lying. He wouldn't endanger this business like that. All right. Kim says, sir, he was only asking a question. It's his job and mine. See that it's covered. Yes, I absolutely will. He calms his breathing. Sorry, it's been a bit of a day, and now a hole in the wall. All right, you've been notified. Thank you. I'll patch it up personally. Was there something else about the establishment? I hope not. No. I'd like to warn him about the hole in reality, but... So I got 3 points now. I'll try for this map wall. Or should I spend a point trying to figure this guy out? Composure. Composure is 4. And what if he's the killer? Maybe we need to figure that out. Composure. Oh, I can't. I can't level it up anymore. All right. You know what I'm going to do, though? Well, first I'm going to put my flashlight away. Let's see, now here. Oh, motorway south, right? Oh, it... Right, okay. The map wall and then motorway south. Map wall first, then we'll undo that. Because it's unchecked. It's unchecked the, what do you call it? The skill check. So if I undo it now, I might... It might... The skill check might be, gone. This wall. Is it a map wall? Or is it just a mall? A mural? Used to be here or something? Just an ordinary wall. Nothing to see here. Very low, though. Why am I looking at this wall? Yeah, why? It's a wall. An ordinary wall. Lieutenant sighs. Why must we stop to look at this wall every time we pass by? We have business to attend to. Yeah, it's very low, isn't it? I have 3 points. What kind of check is it? Conceptualization. Oh, that's so high already. Screw it. Alright, let's get another thought going. I'm gonna undo motorway south. It's only plus one in Land Empire, and we did all the intellect checks. This takes a long time. This seems important, though. About his past. White mourning. About his past as well. I'm not gonna take that. I'm not doing the race theory. Fairweather. Wasteland of reality. 20 hours. Insulindian miracle. What does it mean? How do you know it by heart? Cleaning out the rooms. Let's do this. There's a lot that I want to do, but let's do the bow collector. If we even get to finish it before the end. Who knows? Oh, can we talk to Cindy the Skull? I forgot about these people in here. Is she over here? I don't see her. And what if the cleaning lady's in here?
Give me a moment.
Let me see if I can find her. Cindy. Because she made that graffiti. I was thinking maybe we could talk to her about it. Oh, wait. 100 tiny feet scurrying beneath the grate, the rats of the city. I don't think there's anything up here, right? No. I don't see a need to mess with Kuno's dad. Or, the poor lady with the reported dead husband. Who was missing, then found dead. There's not much else to do. So I'm going to call in an episode here. Next episode, guys, I'm going to run off screen if nothing important or interesting happens. I'll meet you back at Lillian, the net picker. See if she will let us take her boat across to the island there. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.